Cabbage soup!
Every day! Cabbage soup!
for 17 years and you deserve to say hi?
George, she didn't say hi. She said flavor shifters, mine.
Who's wearing a tie?
Where did you get my underwear?
She didn't say hi, tie, or why. She said flavor shifters, mine. Mine.
I'm looking for.
Nobody's having pie, Dad. Just have your soup as always.
As of yesterday, my career total stands at 7,800,276.
That must be a world record!
Close!
I've lost some toes!
Nobody's having toes!
Papa, do you think one day I might be able to get a job at the toothpaste factory?
For your sake, Charlie, I hope not.
Now what kind of positive thinking is that? Charlie's gonna learn from Mr. Monk of making chocolate bars!
Grandpa Joe, don't go feeling that boy's having candy.
Really? I got one!
She said candy.
What?
Candy!
I'm not deaf, you know.
You gotta remember that Charlie's descended from a long line of distinguished candy men.
And women.
But Wonka hasn't hired anyone since Slugworth's spy stole his candy balloon recipe.
Wonka was so angry. He gathered all his workers together and told them, I'm sorry, but you must all go home. And he locked the gate of the factory forever.
But Mr. Walker still makes candies. It's long on my way to school.
Yes, but no one goes in and no one comes out. Shadow workers.
Maybe the undead.
Grandpa Joe, we're going to give the boy nightmares again.
No.
Charlie, want to play gin?
Play gin?
Come in!
Charlie, why don't you see if anyone's done with today's newspapers?
Okay, Dad, you have to figure it out, George.
Here you go. Fresh cabbage soup.
I'm over Lincoln!
See these children? They meet outside Charlie's house every single day with a shiny nickel and piece to get a Wonka bar from the local candy man. The kid with no nickel is Charlie.
Come on, Charlie. Don't you want some candy?
Not today. Thanks. You want a special diet?
It looks like it's working. Help me pick something out. I got a nickel.
You've already got a lollipop. Shouldn't you finish it first?
I can't help it. I love candy. Chocolates, caramel, drawbreaker, suckers, anything!
Stop it! You're making my mouth water.
I can't stop eating sweets, all those wonderful Willy Wonka treats. You can't keep the others, 'cause me, I'm a walker.
Hey, go on, I'm a walker.
When it comes to candy, Willy's a comer.
The candy man can. ego. What is the world coming to when a family can't even afford a newspaper?
Devoted.
Critics may say Augustus is a
question more role models, given the alarming rise in childhood obesity.
Well, he's a little fat. What's wrong with that? It's better seeing you some sort of hooligan, shooting our cigars and raising the havoc. Isn't it my little Piggly Wiggly? And what I always say, don't I always say it? Now say it with me, now say it with me. Eat more, eat more, eat more! Boy Augustus, say it again!
Eat more!
Oh, good boy Augustus. We've been training him for this day ever since our little Piggly Wiggly was born.
Wait, training?
Oh, yeah. Are you going to eat as much as Augustus? He has to be in training from morning to the night, eating all kinds of sweets. If this was the Olympics, Augustus would have the gold medals.
Feeding him fruits for breakfast, plus melon, tomato, cereal, bananas, and beans. Fried red bacon, tomatoes, good mushrooms, and tomatoes, you must buy some beans. Coffee, toast, biscuits, butter, and water, lots of sweet meats, and meat treats galore.
And what does Augustus do at breakfast through?
I eat more.
Girlies only found that lousy golden ticket. So,
I let her take that lucky piece of chocolate home to her 17 children. Oh, you see, I didn't have the heart not to. You know what I mean?
Oh, philanthropic.
Daddy, now you speak sarcastic. I want you fired. You hear me? Fired, fired, fired!
And this is finished out where the sweet is rapidly turning sour.
With nuts? Don't forget the nuts, yes!
Right. Seems like you can't have chocolate without the nuts. Good luck, Veronica.
It's Veruca!
So, after just one day, there are only three golden tickets left. Stay tuned for the continuous coverage on this extraordinary contest. Let's just hope that one deserving kid is among the five. Trout out.
You don't need people when you have robot gizmos.
Don't worry, Dad. You never liked our job anyways. Maybe now you can get back into the candy business like Grandpa Joe keeps saying.
Grandpa Joe likes to dream big dreams, Charlie. But big dreams doesn't put food on the table. I don't know what to tell your mother. It was hard enough now, but now it's gonna be...
Don't worry, Dad. Just stay positive.
Positive? Why?
Why not? Nothing to lose, so why not choose to think positive? Whenever my luck is on the blink, I think positive. Whenever I'm feeling down and out and don't know what to do, I never give way to fear and doubt. Thinking positive sees me through. Whenever my stars are out of sync, I think positive. That's more like it. Whenever you're feeling low or lost, just stay positive with me.
You're wasting your time to count the cost. Just thinking positive, that comes free.
That's why positive is the way to live. Whenever I'm feeling on the brink, I think positive. The moment I do, I'm in the pink, I think positive. Remember this song when things go wrong, then you know what to do. In no time you'll be thinking positive too.
Charlie, this is the most fun I've had, especially when the factory manager got his tongue stuck in the conveyor belt. Now, let's go. I'm positive we're having something special for supper tonight.
Leftover cabbage soup?
No, fresh cabbage soup!
Remember this song when things go wrong, then you know.
So, the Bucket family went from morning to night with horrible rumblings in their tummy. Charlie felt it worst of all. But once a year, Charlie gets a very special treat.
Surprise! Happy birthday, Charlie!
Surprise!
forget you! Happy birthday, Charlie!
Mom, Dad, it's Charlie's day.
He's right, come on, Charlie, show us what thinking positive is all about.
No. Don't be too disappointed if you don't find what you're looking for.
The thing to remember is, no matter what happens, you still got that bar of candy.
I thought we were gonna get up a bar of candy!
Wait, that's what I just said, bar of candy!
I love a jar of candy!
She said he was gonna give her the bar of candy.
Who's got the bar of candy?
Charlie!
I'm right here, you know.
Come on, Charlie, open it.
Okay, here goes.
For goodness sake, open it, boy!
Please open it, you're making me jump. You always grumpy, you even born grumpy.
But I love you just the same. Hey, Charlie, open it up to see if you want.
Nothing. Who wants a piece?
We wouldn't dream of it, Charlie.
Come on, Dad. Have a piece. There's something special after losing your job.
What?
This can't be true. Charlie, that's not funny. Please tell me that's not true.
We'll starve.
It is true, and we will not starve. What's this for, Charlie? Why don't you turn on the radio?
Mr. Bucket's right. What's a little more electricity? Go on, Charlie. Turn on the radio.
Really? This is the best birthday ever!
We interrupt the Orphan Annie Radio Hour to bring you this important news flash. In the past hour, a third golden ticket has been found. We're live in Paris, France, and here they are. So tell me what your name is, miss.
Violet Beauregard.
Violet, sweetie. Twink. Stop chewing your ghost, Melody. Stop making my fall. Remember what your therapist said about acting out.
I get it, Ma. You slap your jaws more than I do.
Violet, I do not appreciate that sort of language. Two words, ask me nicely.
No problem. Hey, Ma, would you please can it? I'm being interviewed here.
Now, Violet, tell us about the golden ticket.
Well, naturally, I'm a gum chewer. In fact, I adore gum. Love it. I chew gum all day long. Except when I'm eating. And I take it out of my mouth and put it behind my ear like this.
Oh, isn't that clever? She's so clever, she's done that all by herself.
Cool it, Ma. And when I sleep, I put it on the headboard. So in the morning, all I have to do is pop it back in my mouth and start chewing again.
She thought of that too. She's so clever.
Sometimes, it's a little hard to get started. One time it even got stuck in my hair. But Mom cut it out and went right on chewing it. It was a hairy moment, though.
Isn't that just hilarious?
Very witty, Violet. Now, tell us more about the golden ticket.
Keep your pants on, Phineas. I'm getting to it. So like I said, naturally, I'm a gum chewer. When I heard about the contest, I laid off the gum and switched straight to candy bars. But now, of course, I'm right back on the gum again. In fact, I've been chewing this piece for over 3 months solid. I'm beating the record set by my best friend, Cornelia Prince Metal. Hi, Cornelia! Listen to this. That's the sound of you losing. Listen some more. Chew on that, Princess Prince Metal.
Ladies and gentlemen, Waka Bar sales have rocketed up to over 200,000 an hour. And this just in, a fourth golden ticket has been found. We're live in Television City, California, and you're not. The second time. Leaving only the fifth and final golden ticket to be found. We're live at the home of Mike TV, the lucky finder of golden ticket number 4. Here's Miss Evie now. Tell us about finding the golden ticket, ma'am.
Mike and I are just chit chatting. Good night, I'm turning up an intro. This is the best part. Crack, smack, whack, dead. Did you see that guy die? That was so totally awesome.
Oh, we gathered, Mike. Now, Miss Stevie, about the golden ticket.
Stevie, the National Suicide Bomb Dude. Wait a minute, freeze frame. It's my phone. Talk to me. Talk to me.
Mike, would you mind telling us?
Keep your chat, Mr. Warner, Empire here. Gotta go. Catch you later. Okay, Oprah, what do you want?
Mike, I'd like you to tell
me. Dude, I love this show. Wait, you play me?
So I see. Now, Mike, tell us about the golden ticket.
What? Yeah, well, I guess I got the big shiny ticket, though. Big deal. He's giving up half my day over my favorite show towards some stupid chocolate factory, which will probably have a crappy sales section. Forgive me, Oprah, baby. Gotta change the channel.
Now, which school does their latest golden ticket
winner? Check her out!
Now, which school does their latest golden ticket winner attend?
School? Are you joking or just crazy? I got the net, TV, and my Game Boy, fool. It's like electric trains, it's something like 2 years of waves, you're earning university degree. I can share the first knowledge, I can be a cool college, me, I see it all on TV. Some kids like to sing and dance, and some kids go to Paris, France, while others visit Washington, D.C. I don't want a single thing, cause I can download anything, it's all on my computer for free. Some kids go to baseball games while other kids have views to say it's like 10 days out of Boy Scout Jamboree. Talk with me, kids, read books of arts, I play, enjoy the universe, not my hand in 10 games like me. Some kids like to fire balloons or play the latest pop jam TV while others want to surf and watch TV. I can visit one of the moons of Tokyo without leaving home.
Thank you.
The weather turned as cold as Willy Wonka's Choco Ice Cream Supreme. First came the snow, drifting through the steel blue sky. And then came the wind. All the Bucket family could do was scrape up enough food to last a cold winter's night. Mr. Bucket looked for odd jobs like shoveling snow, while little Charlie was on his uphill trek to school.
Charlie, where's your coat?
I haven't got a coat.
Haven't got a coat? Here, take my scarf. You'll freeze to death.
Oh, thank you so much. You making it around?
Well, I was hoping to, but it's too cold. I'm just trying to get back to the shop before all the candy freezes. Mind helping me pack up, would you?
Sure thing.
Thanks.
Oh, no.
Oh, blast it. My fingers are so cold I can barely feel them. Say, Charlie, mind grabbing the box of Nut Crunchies for me?
Sure.
Thanks.
What's this? A silver dollar? I think you must have dropped this.
Wow, a silver dollar. No, it's not mine. Why don't you go take it home to your folks?
You think I should?
Yeah, that thing's probably been buried in the snow for weeks. Take it, Charlie. And you know what? Take this for being such a good kid.
Really?
Really? It looks like you're starving.
Thanks so much. We better get off to school. Thanks. Can I just one more? Just one more? I don't even pay for it.
Well, I don't see why not. You know, I would give you another one, but the boss is pretty strict about inventory lately. So, what will it be, Charlie, my boy?
Well, I think I want to share this with my family. Grandpa Joe likes the Wibble Scrunchies Fudge Mountain Delight, while Grandpa Josephine likes the Nutterlific.
So here, why don't you get the Wibble Scrunchies Nutterlific Totally Twisted Combo Board? Just that. Oh, here we go. And here you go. Now, Charlie, I know you want to go home and share it and all, but maybe you should taste it first. You know, to make sure you like it too. That's all.
On the one hand, you are just a bar of chocolate, no different from the rest. On the other hand, you are the superstar of chocolate, the gold key to Willy Wonka's treasure chest. Whichever you are, I got it.
really his!
So Charlie, who do you want to take with you on the tour?
Well, I wish I could take all of them. But if I'm going to choose one, then it has to be Grandpa Joe.
He's the most!
Oh no, I'm not!
Not you, Joe!
I'll leave you all!
Who are you calling on? I've been waiting for this my entire life! Help me out of bed, Charlie, I'll race to the factory! I see the day, right out of face, the world is saying good morning!
Look at the sun!
Make that a million and one nuts. Your ticket?
Here's your ticket.
But there's absolutely no gum chewing allowed on the tour.
You make gum!
Violet, Wonka told you no gum allowed. Do we need to negotiate?
Simple babble, whatever.
My TV and guest!
Put your golden horses, Professor! I'm right about to meet this boss!
I'm sorry, there's a ticket.
Super delicious. Oh, Mike, I'm happy to announce that there's absolutely no video game playing allowed on the tour.
None?
None whatsoever. Charlie Bucket!
Yeah.
Oh. So you're Charlie Bucket. Odd coincidence, you're finding your ticket at the very last moment on the very last day.
Now, you see here, Mr. Walker, our ticket is just...
Pleasure to meet you, Mr.
John. Joe Bucket, I used to work for you, Mr. Walker.
Congratulations, so did I. All right, now, we start with a contract. Step in, we don't have a lot of time. Come on, let's move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Raise your right hand. I, Charlie Bucket, hereby swear not to touch my line or time.
Touch my line aside.
The first party of the first part. C4 for details. Better than not be included. I stand for you larger than the mirror. Do you swear?
We swear.
Not to touch my lawyer. Let me just give him a quick ring.
No phones. Any questions from the children?
Hey, Wonks, how long is this gonna take? Not about a minute, in about 20.
Any questions from the parents?
Mr. Wonka, how long until Augustus might have a snack? He has low blood sugar.
Go to Mr. Wonka. Oh my goodness. I can't. Just make it clear, please. I can't wait to send this to Grandma.
No photography.
Mr. Bucko, just how many rooms has your factory?
Good question, Augustus.
In the Wonka Chocolate Factory, there are several thousand. He's reading in bed at night, and in that room, hear the exploding spoons, and enemies start a fight. In this room here, all the rocket mines, they say that it's 3 miles deep. And in room in there are the marshmallow dudes, much more than this room. Chocolate cows from which we get chocolate milk. And in that room, hear the hot candy as the cold days descend.
Yes! Isn't everything? to fill every bathtub and pool in the world. If you find Million One.
Imagine Zach Augustus, hot and cold, running chocolate.
Hey, Vanka, I want to taste some hot and cold.
Augustus, you must not touch my chocolate.
Look over there. It's some sort of creature. Put your hands up where I can see it, Pop.
No, no. Those are my friends. Those are Oompa Loompas.
Zombie workers?
Not a zombie worker, a refugee.
From where exactly, Wonka?
All my Oompa Loompas come from Loompa Land.
Well, Wonka, you see our geography teacher.
Then you'll know all about Loompa Land. With its thick jungles and its horn swappers and wangoodles and zipple zapples.
Wangoodles? There's no such thing.
Oh, there is, my dear. And what a land you'll just love to sink its super shark fangs into you. Augustus, didn't I say you must not eat my chocolate?
Too late!
Great!
He's gonna get his cold to millions of people!
It's so good! I see some strong life and get shrunken!
Okay, here we are. Let's move. 1, 2, 3. Please step in. Watch your step. Watch your step. Watch your. Do not hit the boat. You're only making silly. Watch
your step. Excuse me, Mr. Wonka. I just love your hat. It really sets off your eyes. But of course you have great taste. You know, I would simply adore a pink candy boat, and maybe one of those sweet little Oompa-Loompas to drive it for me.
All right. I know it's time to bring out the old checkbook, and don't take me on too much of a boat ride. Wonka, I may need my nuts one day.
Matters is what?
What?
I said,
matters is what?
What exactly?
Hey, Wonka, where the heck are you taking us?
Oh, Oh!
cyanide chemicals, primarily the psychoactive component being ferrobrine and caffeine. Oh, Charlie, please do stick with the tour. I would hate to see you float away. Come on. Here we are, the nut room.
Miss Halonka, are you squirrels?
Yes. These squirrels are so talented, they can remove a shell from a nut in one piece and decide whether or not if it's a good nut or a bad nut.
That's so adorable. Here's Brother Squirrely.
But you must not disturb my squirrels. They are in training.
See here, Wampa. I want a squirrel, and what I want, I get.
Right.
Checkbook's ready.
I want a squirrel and an Oompa Loompa. I want a squirrel and an Oompa Loompa and a paint hat. And while we're at it, I want a feast. I want a bean feast. Cream buns and donuts and fruit cakes with no nuts. So good you can donuts. Give it to me. Now, I want a ball. I want a party. Pink macaroons and a million balloons and performing baboons and give it to me. Now, I want a party with fruit balls of laughter. I want a ton of ice cream. And if I don't get the things I am after, I'm gonna scream. I want the works. I want the home works. Presents and prizes and sweets and surprises of all shapes and sizes. And now,
I'm gonna turn big puddle for you.
Thank you.
fault. It was my idea. I suggested we go look in Tate and visit the kid in the first place.
Well, then you both are to blame. But I haven't got time for that now. You see, today was a competition, and that competition had one purpose in mind, and that purpose was to find the person to make you candy dreams come true when I retire.
I understand.
Charlie, come on. Today was just a test of character. I carefully selected each room that could tempt each of our golden ticket winners. But you, Charlie, come on. Charlie, you did something quite remarkable. You gave me the temptation, and even though you did get caught, you admitted your guilt. Now come on, we got so much more planning to do.
Where are you taking us?
You see, Charlie, I might not be in trouble, but you might be. You see, time will tell, Charlie. You know, it's only a matter of time until you find yourself in life-threatening trouble, Charlie. All right, we're here. Come on.
Well, what's this?
Oh, well, you see, it's a little rusty. I haven't used it in a long time. All right, Charlie. Press that button.
This one?
No, that one. All right. Hold on tight. We're going up and out.
Up and out?
Charlie,
you don't need to worry about that. I've got that all taken care of.
Charlie!